Ghostbusters, $11. Holy moly. It's not the old days, but it's the old days. Look at all the vintage. Oh my goodness. Okay, we got a lot of Padmes. Battle Droid. TIE. Skywalker. There's about 3 or 4 cases here. Sweet. Should I pick up a battle droid? Alright. Sweet. Ooh. I'm gonna grab one of each of these guys. And picked him up. Ooh, look at that guy. And of course we got Jar Jars down here. They're gonna be there for a while. Nobody wants Jar Jar. We got Halo. Awesome. Look at that. Sweet. Take 2 of those. I found this stuff on clearance. $7.50. This was $11.99, normally $40. This was normally $79, but it's actually $23. I just checked it at the scanner. I checked these at the scanner too. So at the scanner, it was $7.50. I gotta go check the rest of the clearance. Air. Oh, we've got 4 Ectos here. So, I'm gonna go check some prices on these here. See what we got going. I think these are clearance. There's a lot of droids. Let's see what we got here. Price machine. First, I'm gonna check this one just to see where it's at. That one has not gone down. Princess Leia, you still full price? Yes. You never know. Now watch this one. $25.99. $7.49. $7.49, folks. And I got Luke here. Let's see if he. Oh, $13.49. All right, so we're going to pick up. I'm picking up this guy and Luke. How many of these do I want? At pretty much, you know, 75% off. I have to grab 2 for sure. You know, give it 2 months on eBay. Best Buy. What you got, Best Buy? What you got? You got some little guys, and we got the Black Series. Oh, we got a Captain Rex. Perfect card. I already have him. I can't bring myself to spend $100 on 2 of these, because you need to have 2. You can't just buy a half of one. You gotta make this whole thing here. All you get is that. You want to have that. I've seen it online. 34-ish, maybe? 40-ish? Say, I would get this for the droid, but I already have that droid. I don't need a mouse droid. I don't like any of those troopers from the First Order. See, I have a droid like that, but
Is it exactly like that? I don't think so. But this is a good clearance weight. Look how many they've got. The Galactic Empire. $30. That's $6 a piece. Wait.
Because the only one I want in there is a droid. Well, he's kind of cute. Princess Leia. Yeah, well, that's Best Buy. Let's get out of here. Scooby-Doo. Elizabeth.
The Hiss.
Alright, I have a feeling about that. Yes? Okay. Oh, here's the rest of them. I don't have that one, I don't have that one, and I have the one with the black suit. They changed the package. It used to be cardboard on this section here. Alright, I'm gonna go price check these. Oh, what's this? Haha, that guy's got sunglasses. Oh, there's a motor. Let's go price check this too. Alright. Pile up the loot.
Let's go price check it. I think there's... yeah, it's right over there. Let's hit that again. Check that out. At Target, they have this one, but not the 3 3/4. This guy's pretty cool. I don't know if I want to get him. I got Grief again. And Peg Warmer. This 3 3/4 would be nice. This version, I don't have this version, but I don't really like it. Hello. That's gonna be sold. The great toy hunt is over, and here is my bounty.
So we went to Walmart first because I found these online. Walmart online. No picture, no label, just Star Wars Vintage, $12.99. And they said they had 8 of them in stock. So I went in. First, I bought two. I bought one, and then I'm like, maybe I should buy two. I bought two, and then I'm like, I better get over there before they even tell me it's ready to pick up. They have this pickup thing. Never tried it before. Actually, it works really good. So I ordered them, just in case they sold out before I got over there. I was like, it's got to be new if they don't even have a picture up yet. And so, it's a little windy out today, tonight. So, yeah, that was this morning. It's nighttime, so it's evening. January the 20th. So if you're wondering if you want to go hunting, you can still go, you know, tomorrow and probably find some stuff, especially if you go in the morning. But, yeah. So I went to Walmart, and they had 4 cases of these you saw. And so I didn't need to buy any of these guys, I already had them like pickup paid for. So, and I have one of her coming, and so Padme's coming. Wasn't sure if I was gonna get this guy, but you know, I buy two of everything, so I got two of this guy. And then I didn't really want to buy this droid, but I'm like, I'm gonna have all these vintage cards from 2020. I'm going to be missing this one. Probably regret it. So I picked it up. It's never going to go down in value. The figure is horrible. I mean, as far as, check this out. It's just a really old one. As far as I can tell, it's like the original battle droid from Phantom Menace. And they, you know, there's just, you only got your joints here. But there's no turning of wrists or anything. And the only reason you'd want to get this is, I guess, if you're collecting vintage cards. You're just like, I need a droid card, battle droid card. I'm not even sure if they've ever... Oh, this is a DC-78. So yeah, they've already made this before. If you don't have it, go out to get it. Walmart's got them. Like, 2 Walmarts had them. 3. 3 Walmarts had them. One just had one case, and the whole case was just, it was like an accordion. It was just like, rah, let me just get it. But the case that when I was at Walmart today, they were all perfect. Every single one. The first one. The second one. I was just like, oh my gosh. I forgot to film it. I should have filmed the accordion, you know, the horror show. So I got those. Picked this guy up at Target. Saw him twice. I don't buy 2 of the 6-inch because you can take them out of the box, and if you really want them, you can put them back in the box. We got Luke. $13. I hadn't bought them yet. I wasn't really going to buy this one, but you can't pass up Luke and Yoda for $13. That's the same price as a 1 vintage. So we got that. Now, I already had this guy. I bought this guy when he first came out, and I was so excited to get Hondo's droid. And so I've already done a review of this, but it's on clearance. You saw it in the video, it probably. $7.50, $7.49. Go get yourself Hondo's droid, the R5P8. Clearance. So, I bought them all. Oh yeah, I bought them all. Yo, I got a lot of them. Five, ten, six. Okay. There's $7 today. They're a Target exclusive. Black Series is probably the most popular thing in toys right now.
6 inch. You do the math. 2 months from now.
Okay. Hey, you didn't get them before they went on clearance. You can't be mad at me. You can't be mad at the clearance game. All right. And then I saw this when I was a kid.
They had Play Mobile. And, they had Play Mobile. We got G.I. Joe, Fisher-Price Adventure, Fisher-Price Adventure people, and then we started getting Star Wars, and then G.I. Joe. Never had room for these. I thought this was kind of cool. If nothing else, I'm going to use a surfboard for my 3 3/4, and I think this jet ski will fit for my 3 3/4. Oh, I'm planning to do some movies and stuff. There's big plans, so... 3 3/4. Remember, anything 3 3/4 goes. I love it. Star Wars, G.I. Joe, Buck Rogers, Fortnite, Scooby-Doo, Terminator. I don't know anything. Marvel, DC. Make it in 3 3/4. It's coming on the show. Okay, so we walked by Ghostbusters. There were 11. So I bought in Bill Murray. I already have Bill Murray. I bought him for $20 because Bill Murray is awesome. I could use another suit to put another head on, and then I could take. And then I was like, oh, I could use another Bill Murray head to put on something else at some point in time if I wanted to. So I for sure always have one good Ghostbuster complete. But I can have another one where I can use Bill Murray's head. Because look at Bill Murray. I mean, it's perfect. And then, I didn't buy Dan Aykroyd. I wanted to, but I didn't want to spend another $20 on him. So, well, he was clearance too. He doesn't have a sticker on, but he was $11. So I only have one of him. And, you gotta have Sigourney Weaver. Now, I'm kind of going for the head sculpt. I mean, I'll keep it as all one, but I'm thinking in the future head sculpt, doing some figure bashing. Maybe. We'll see.
We'll see.
All right. So Ghostbusters. And then moving on to Marvel. Yeah, more 6 inch. I saw this, I was like, yeah, I'm going to buy that. And then I'm like, $50? No, I don't want it that bad. $14.99? No. Now we're talking. That's a whole nother story. That is a really good figure. I think I did a short review of this on a toy hunt in the past, but it's a great figure. It's just, I didn't want to spend $50 on it. But now they're $14.99. Well, buy one to keep in the package, one to open, and one to pay for the other two. Couple months, go on eBay, probably be paying regular price. How are you going to be paying regular price tomorrow?
Ghostbusters.
Alright. I just like toys. They're just cool. I play Fortnite a little bit. A little bit here or there. People like Fortnite. It's on clearance. It's on super clearance. Even if I didn't want it, it's probably a good thing to buy. But I like them. So, I'll probably end up keeping them. But this is the first one I found. That was kind of funny. Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. And then there's the actual building stuff to build it up like Hive. So that's kind of cool. I thought that was pretty neat. It says 1999. Got it for 11 bucks. Alright. Oh, you want to look at the back? That's the back looks like. I look at these in the store every once in a while, but I usually buy them. I've been buying them when they go to Ross. They're like $4.99. So I've got like, I think 8. And then I bought a box set of 4. One with the, like the furries. It's that like a pink teddy bear. You know, what people dress up as like furries or whatever. It's kind of like that. I thought it was really funny. That was, I mean, there's 3 other ones in there. Maybe it was a 5-pack. I don't know. That was the one I was going for, was the weird pink, the chick dressed in a pink bear outfit. I thought that was funny. So, I also got this. You can see it pretty good. It's a season, or no, the chapter 1 collection. So, from each season, 1 through 10. I really think the banana guy is funny. And I was like, oh, I'm going to get that banana guy at some point. And I kept seeing him in like 6-inch. And come in like multi-packs. I had no idea. So this thing is $79. It's normally 80 bucks. I got it for 23. It says 39 on the thing, but when I scanned it, I think I showed that in a video, but when I scanned it, it was 23. And then I went to a second Target, and I found another one, same price. So I've never sold anything on eBay before. My wife tells me, you buy all this stuff to sell, but you never sell anything. I know, because it's too cool. It's really hard to sell toys once you got them. So anyway, that's the haul. That was my haul for today. Amazing clearance. Get out there and try and find some deals. There's probably some more. There are other 2-packs. You might get lucky. There might, you know, you might be able to find a Wolverine or Professor X. Go out in there and look. When you go to Target, check the end caps. So you know you have the aisle, and on the end, check those. Especially where there isn't like in the main traffic aisle, like the back one where the board games on one side and all the end caps there. Check there. They also at Target had at the end where they start having sports stuff. Between the sports and the toys, they had some clearance stuff in the aisle there. So check there. Sometimes some of the clearance stuff was showing up over in like the NECA and the collector's area. So check everywhere in the toy area. When you go to Walmart, they actually have a clearance section. Sometimes they have yellow balloons. So you can look for like yellow signs and yellow balloons, like all yellow. Or just ask somebody, hey, where's your clearance aisle? Every Walmart has one. Sometimes they're over in the auto. Sometimes they're right on the end of the toys. Sometimes somewhere really weird up front or something. So just ask. You know, each Walmart's a little bit different. Otherwise, the clearance is just in the aisle. Always look under the shelves. Look under the shelves and behind big things, especially if there's a lot of something. That's the tricks. I don't know why people hide it and come back. Just buy it. You don't have the money right then, or it's a store employee, or it just falls and just gets kicked underneath. Like underneath, you know, like stuff rolls under. You never know. Okay, so we also have. This was the score of the day, right here. So I was watching YouTube like a couple days ago, and this guy, I can't remember, Cave Hunter or something, I don't know. He passed right by this, and I could have swore that there was a yellow tag light. You know, he was doing like a toy hunt, you know, video, just like I just did. And, I could have swore there was a yellow sticker by this. And there was like 3 or 4 of them at that Walmart. So when I saw this, I was like, you know what? Let's go check it out. I even said, I was like, I think I got a feeling about this in the video. And sure enough, $6, bro. $6. Like, it's $25, so, you know, oh, yeah, you know, you're saving almost $20. But this thing is hard to find. It doesn't make any sense. Why are Walmart and Target putting popular things on clearance so early? Their shelves are empty. Their pegs are empty. They could leave them on there. It's not like they need the real estate. They don't need the space. Why? I'll buy it. But the problem is what about the people that didn't get this and wanted it? You know, you're not going to be able to find it now. So buying this for $6, I mean, it's really not worth 25. It's worth more than 25 if you could find one. A lot of people can't even find them. I can't believe I found on clearance. Same thing happened with Boba Fett. The retros, like, I think they were $10 normal. I never saw any retros in any of my Walmarts. I have 3 Walmarts I go to, mostly. There's like another 3 that I can go to if I'm really ambitious. But, why would you... I don't know why they do that. It doesn't make any sense. It's like, they're G.I. Joe. You don't have to put them on clearance. Somebody's going to come through and go, wow, that's G.I. Joe. I'm a buy. But I'll take it for $6. The great thing is I never had one of these when I was a kid. I had both G.I. Joe tanks. We had all the boats. We had the snow stuff. I never got this tank. I didn't like it. I didn't think it looked like real tanks, like any kind of real tank. And I was more for like the real tanks and Jeeps and stuff I like more than the science fiction make-believe. And I always thought this was a science fiction make-believe, even though, I mean, you could, it is very cool. I've always liked it. But when I was real young, this wasn't on the top of my list. And then, you know how they cycled through stuff? Just never came back to this one. I own it now. And the cool thing is, it is exactly the same thing as when I was like 10, 12. I got G.I. Joe 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Didn't really kind of stop playing toys around 12, 7th grade. StarCom came out in like 7th and 8th grade. My brother's 3 years younger than me. I had to get StarCom. Those were really cool with the magnet feet. I'll do a review of my StarCom sometime. When I finished with them, I was older. And I put them all in plastic bags. They all had, like, cards like the G.I. Joes, you know, like this card. But and they had, like, their data. And there was, like, a cartoon form and stuff. And I had every single one. And I put all their weapons, the card, and the guy, each in little sandwich bags. My brother decided he was going to play with them, which was fine. But he never put them all back. So they're all in just a pile in this box. It would have been awesome if they'd been how I put them. Because I was like, I'm going to keep these really good. It's like 40, you know, it's 30 some years later now. And I'm like, man, it would have been nice if those had been kept away. Now, my brother made up for it because he did that with all the G.I. Joes. He didn't put the card, but he put all the G.I. Joes in plastic bags. Which is great because when I pulled them out of the box last year, all the rubber bands were broken. So there's just all pieces of G.I. Joes. So some of the bags had like 2 or 3 G.I. Joes, maybe 4 tops. So, you know, you could figure out the parts. Could you imagine a whole box of just pieces and parts of G.I. Joes? I mean, I'd figure it out. You know which parts go where. But he redeemed himself with the plastic bags. He probably has no idea. He'll probably never watch this either. But this is great. I love it. This was at, so I have all the other 2-packs, but I don't have this 2-pack. It was $5 at Big Lots. It was the only Star Wars thing they had at Big Lots right now. And they only had this. It was just this. It was just sitting there. So the other ones that come with this, oh, maybe there was one more on the shelf. It was the little Padawan that fights rocks with one of like her red guards or something. Yeah, I don't like those movies. You know what I'm talking about. The Padawan who likes to just fight rocks. She's very good at fighting rocks. Really good. She can cut a giant boulder in half after whacking at it for about 10 minutes. Isn't that amazing? Oh, it's so great. Fight rocks with your lightsaber. All right, last one. So this new set of these came out, and I'm like, oh yeah, I gotta get him. So he's great. He's got like this sinister grin on his face. I don't know if I can. If it won't go in real good, I have it facing the other way. Yeah, this guy's great. These 4-inch. I haven't done any reviews of these. I have almost every single one. I'm going to do a whole review of the set. I keep putting them in my DC box. And then, you know, I see them hanging. So I see them all the time, all these figures. But I just haven't opened any of them up yet. Well, actually, I did open some up. I did a review on an old camera, but I never put it. That was one before I put anything on YouTube. I was making videos, but I wasn't posting anything. So anyway, that's it. Have a good one, everybody. There.